So let's first of all talk about what is Android. All right. So the person that you see here on the left of your screen is Andy Rubin. So he is the co-founder of Android Inc. That is nowadays more than 1 million Android devices are using. All right. So it is an operating system that was offered to us by Andy Rubin, and every day more than 1 million new Android devices are activated. So it's a huge user base that we are talking about in terms of user acceptance. So the larger the user base, the more is the demand for the operators, or say for the providers of services to these devices. So that is where we step in. We as Android developers are the ones who are actually catering to the needs of all the daily users by creating various business enterprise applications to serve the various business needs of the industry. Let's also talk about what exactly is the ecosystem that this particular thing works on, or the Android framework works on. So there is a wide variety of devices manufacturers that make use of Android framework in order to customize their own needs. For example, if I talk about Samsung, all right, Samsung might be creating or leveraging some of the APIs that are available onto the Android framework and may build up a few of the functionalities that they feel like building up on the APIs that are available as a core component to the Android framework. Google, everyone knows Android is powered by Google, so they are the main producers of the Android softwares. Then we have the consumers, or what we say the target user base. So the consumers are the ones that derive the need for using the operating system. The more benefits that they get out of the operating system, the more consumers will be attracted towards the operating system. Then we have the application development houses. Let's come to the point now. I say if I'm building up, or say I'm buying an Android device, what I necessarily mean is, or what my thinking would be is, that I need to have a lot of applications that serve my need. If you talk about the Android Play Store, it has got n number of applications that you can think of. So that is the reason why Android has supremacy over the other operating systems, just because it has got a very sizable, I would say, the App Store. The App Store is something that you people can look into and find any application that you feel may be serving your purpose. So we as Android application developers are the ones who actually create those applications, and that is where we step in. There's also immense opportunity in terms of freelancing projects in Android application. I'll tell you a few things. Majorly, the Android application projects are not that large in size. All right. So what happens is that freelancing projects are easy to bid on with respect to the Android application development program, and also you can create them in a sizable portion. Say within a span of 3 months or 4 months, you'll be able to create an Android application all by yourself. So that is where the freelancers also step in and get the projects out of the companies and also work as a part-time basis. However, apart from the freelancers, also the Android system is also working on in terms of the employability also. So there's a huge demand for Android developers, professionals on a regular basis also in the industry. Android also provides you, the framework also provides you app monetization. So when we talk about, if, for example, what I want to do is I want to create an application for myself, right? I see an idea, I want to create an application, and I have created the idea of the application. But if I make it paid, that is, if I make my application to be downloaded as a paid version, then what I need to do is I need to have the user base decreases, just because my application is now available as a paid category and most of the users might not be downloading the application. But Android also, the Play Store also gives you monetization. You might have seen, how many of you have seen the applications wherein you see a few ads going on anytime you're connected onto the internet? I'll wait for your responses back onto the chat window. How many of you have seen that? The applications getting some advertisements going on. When you click on an advertisement, it opens up a page, and everyone, right? I need some responsiveness from the batch here. Everyone, it's not only on YouTube and Facebook, Sandeep, it's on any number of applications that you download under the free category apart from few applications like the WhatsApp and everything, right? It's like it's a part of monetization that we people do. We integrate an AdMob SDK that will create or say runtime. What it will do is it will create, keep on adding the monetization advertisements. It's more so a pay-per-click concept. Wherever the user clicks on the advertisement, you just get some money out of it into your account. For example, you are having a developer account. You have created an application. You have also placed monetization inside your application using the AdMob SDK. Once the application gets uploaded onto the Play Store, there's a download count that goes on for the application. Depending on how much downloads you have for your application, what you do get is you get money out of it. The money percentage depends on the category of downloads that your application goes into, right? So if your application is the top 50 grossing applications, the money that you get out of the app monetization is a lot larger. And if your application is somewhere in the back stack, what will happen is your app monetization would be giving you some results out of it, right? So that is how the monetization works. So if you have only created an application and you just want to monetize it, that way you can also do it. Everything that you get will be credited to your account, and then you can actually get the PayPal account done.